או תראה, או תראה כמה טוב יהיה בשנה, בשנה הבאה.
We just got out of Pesach. We're all in the midst of Sfirat HaOmer. And we have in the middle, before we end the Sfira, before we get to Shavuot, we're going to hit this week the holiday of Yom HaAtzmaut. The unique component of Yom HaAtzmaut these days is the fact that after 65 years, people are still asking themselves the question, where is Medinat Israel heading towards? And because people are still asking that question, we find different groups in Am Yisrael relating to Yom HaAtzmaut. Some people are totally ignoring it as if it didn't really happen. A very small group actually claims that halachically, religiously, Medinat Yisrael has no significance. And our job in Bnei Akiva, religious Zionists, is to really understand what Yom HaAtzmaut is all about and how Yom HaAtzmaut is giving us such a tremendous opportunity to thank HaKadosh Baruch Hu on where we are, but more than that, that we could refocus our entire devotion to HaKadosh Baruch Hu through the process of redemption. Pesach, everybody looks at Pesach excited about the reality of redemption. No one thinks that Pesach wasn't this unbelievable redemption out of Mitzrayim. We still celebrate it. Shulchan Aruch is full with Hilchot Pesach. The Torah highlights it everywhere it goes. We remember Yetziat Mitzrayim every single day in Kriyat Shema. Kabbalat O Malchut Shamayim in Kriyat Shema is through the holiday of Pesach. But the question is, what will be after Pesach? Pesach was just the beginning. Where is Pesach leading us to? And we know that Sfirat HaOmer is making that connection between Pesach in the beginning to Shavuot Matan Torah. But when you look in the Torah wasn't supposed to end just in Mitzrayim. The Torah was all about bringing us into the land and building, as it says right in Aseret HaDibrot in Kabbalat HaTorah, Ve'atem tiyu li mamlechet kohanim ve'goy kadosh. That's the whole essence of Kabbalat HaTorah, of being a mamlechet kohanim ve'goy kadosh. A mamlechet, ruling the land, having a country that is going to operate as a goy kadosh. When you look in Yetziat Mitzrayim was done in a very quick way, b'chipazon. We were rushed out. And perhaps that could be the reason that people expected that also the days of redemption, la'atid lavo, would look the same way. It will be quick, chick-chack. Bet HaMikdash will just come down mishamayim and everything will happen in seconds. But actually, if you look in the sources, you see that Yetziat Mitzrayim was unique, that it was b'chipazon. If you look in several gemarot and in a pasuk meforash in Yeshayahu, where it speaks that in the future redemption, it's going to be a slow process. The famous Yerushalmi that speaks about the redemption similar to the sunrise. Kim'a kim'a, slowly, slowly. But this point of understanding that redemption in the future is going to be in a slower process. Explains the Maharal, why is it that in Yetziat Mitzrayim it's going to be quick versus in the future it's going to be a slow redemption? Says the Maharal, because in Yetziat Mitzrayim it was done by HaKadosh Baruch Hu. He did it in a second. We had no involvement. It reached a point of Hashem ilachem lachem ve'atem tacharishon. God will just go to battle for us. We do nothing. But in the future redemption, once we enter the land, once we're part of Eretz Yisrael, once Yehoshua took that lead into Kibush Haaretz, already then, it required our involvement. It required already a natural way of redemption. It wasn't just God coming and hitting and doing one big operation and it's done. No, it's a process that we got to be involved in. Says the Maharal, that's the basic difference. It's not just HaKadosh Baruch Hu coming and creating a miracle. It's going to be in a natural way. And when things happen naturally, it's in a slow process. Our obligation today, 65 years later, is to understand and realize that this is a process. And to look at the amazing accomplishment that Medinat Israel brought to us as Jewish people. I would use only one example. Where did we have in our history an army that the bylaws of the army, and people don't realize that, the bylaws of the army of Medinat Israel is all based on halachic component. Kashrut in the kitchens, Shabbat laws. This is unbelievable. What a Kiddush Hashem. We're not there yet. But that's the process we're in. And our obligation is all of us together. Lachgog et Yom Ha'atzmaut. To understand this is a holiday of redemption. To understand that it's exactly the continuation of Pesach Yom Ha'atzmaut that lead us into that moment of Kabbalat HaTorah, of Kabbalat HaTorah, of Mamlechet Kohanim V'Koy Kadosh. With this Simcha of Yom Ha'atzmaut, we'll be able to take our Torah and Shavuot to a Torah that HaKadosh Baruch Hu really hoped us to live life of Torah. Of Torah in Medinat Israel, Chag Sameach, Kol Am Israel.